Circulator. A circulator is a passive non-reciprocal 3 or 4 port device, in which a microwave or radio frequency signal entering any port is transmitted to the next port in rotation. A port in this context is a point where an external waveguide or transmission line connects to the device. For a 3-port circulator, a signal applied to port 1 only comes out of port 2, a signal applied to port 2 only comes out of port 3, a signal applied to port 3 only comes out of port 1, so to up to a phase factor, the scattering matrix for an ideal 3-port circulator is. Optical circulators have similar behavior. Depending on the materials involved, circulators fall into two main categories, ferrite circulators and non-ferrite circulators. Ferrite circulators are radio frequency circulators which are composed of magnetized ferrite materials. They fall into two main classes, 4-port waveguide circulators based on Faraday rotation of waves propagating in a magnetized material, and 3-port Y-junction circulators based on cancellation of waves propagating over two different paths near magnetized material. Waveguide circulators may be of either type, while more compact devices based on strip line are of the 3-port type. Two or more Y-junctions can be combined in a single component to give four or more ports, but these differ in behavior from a true 4-port circulator. A permanent magnet produces the magnetic flux through the waveguide. Ferromagnetic garnet crystal is used in optical circulators. Though ferrite circulators can provide good forward signal circulation while suppressing greatly the reverse circulation, their major shortcomings, especially at low frequencies, are the bulky sizes and the narrow bandwidths. Early work on non-ferrite circulators includes active circulators using transistors that are non-reciprocal in nature. In contrast to ferrite circulators which carry passive devices, active circulators require power. Major issues associated with transistor-based active circulators are the power limitation and the signal-to-noise degradation, which are critical when it is used as a duplexer for sustaining the strong transmit power and clean reception of the signal from the antenna. Reactors offer one solution. One study employed a structure similar to a time-varying transmission line with the effective non-reciprocity triggered by a one-direction propagating carrier pump. This is like an AC-powered active circulator. The research claimed to be able to achieve positive gain and low noise for receiving pad-hand broadband non-reciprocity. Another study used resonance with non-reciprocity triggered by angular momentum biasing, which more closely mimics the way that signals passively circulate in a ferrite circulator. In 1964, Moore presented and experimentally demonstrated a circulator based on transmission lines and switches. In April 2016, a research team significantly extended this concept, presenting an integrated circuit circulator based on N-path filter concepts. It offers the potential for full duplex communication. The device uses capacitors and a clock and is much smaller than conventional devices. When one port of a 3-port circulator is terminated in a matched load, it can be used as an isolator, since a signal can travel in only one direction between the remaining ports. An isolator is used to shield equipment on its input side from the effects of conditions on its output side, for example, to prevent a microwave source being detuned by a mismatched load. In radar, circulators are used as a type of duplexer, to route signals from the transmitter to the antenna and from the antenna to the receiver, without allowing signals to pass directly from transmitter to receiver. The alternative type of duplexer is a transmit-receive switch that alternates between connecting the antenna to the transmitter and to the receiver. The use of chirp pulses and a high dynamic range may lead to temporal overlap of sent and received pulses, however, requiring a circulator for this function. In a future generation cellular communication, people talk about full duplex radios, where signals can be simultaneously transmitted and received at the same frequency. Given the currently limited, crowded spectrum resource, full duplexing can directly benefit the wireless communication by twice of the data throughput speed. Currently, the wireless communication is still performed with half duplex, where either the signals are transmitted or received at different timeframes, if at the same frequency, or the signals are simultaneously transmitted and received at different frequencies. A reflection amplifier is a type of microwave amplifier circuit utilizing negative differential resistance diodes such as tunnel diodes and gun diodes. Negative differential resistance diodes can amplify signals, and often perform better at microwave frequencies than two-port devices. However, since the diode is a one-port device, a non-reciprocal component is needed to separate the outgoing amplified signal from the incoming input signal. By using a 3-port circulator with the signal input connected to one port, the bias diode connected to a second, and the output load connected to the third, the output and input can be uncoupled. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.